When it comes to dielectronics and robotics, one of the biggest questions is, should you use an Arduino or an ESP32? I'm Jenner, and in this video, we'll compare them side by side, test them with real examples, and finally answer the question, which board should you choose in 2025 on your projects? Let's start with the Arduino. First introduced in 2005, it became the symbol of the dielectronics revolution. The Uno, based on the Atmega 328P microcontroller, runs at 16 MHz with 2 KB of SRAM and 32 KB of flash memory. It might sound small today, but its simplicity is exactly what made it successful. The Arduino ecosystem is huge. Countless shields, libraries, sensors, and tutorials exist. From blinking your very first LED to controlling robots, Arduino is the board that has taught millions of people how to code and build circuits, including me. The ESP32, on the other hand, is a younger but more advanced player. Released in 2016 by Espressive Systems, it quickly became the go-to board for IoT projects. And that is mostly because it includes communication systems like Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. So it packs dual-core processors running up to 240 MHz with up to 520 KB of SRAM. And as I said, comes with built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. Features Arduino Uno simply doesn't have. So the ESP32 is like a big brother of Arduino, more powerful, more connected, and surprisingly cheaper. Now let's put the specs side by side. Arduino Uno has 14 digital I/O pins, 6 analog inputs, and operates at 5 volts logic. And the ESP32, depending on the module, can have over 30 GPIO pins with 12-bit ADCs, capacitive touch sensors, SPI, I2C, UARTs, PWM, and even a digital to analog converter. And the ESP32 isn't just faster. It also supports multitasking with its dual core design, which allows you to, for example, read sensors on one core while handling Wi-Fi tasks on the other. Power consumption is another factor. Arduino Uno is simple. It usually runs at around 50 milliamps. And the ESP32 with Wi-Fi active can consume 100 to 250 milliamps depending on usage. But here's the trick. The ESP32 supports deep sleep modes, dropping the power consumption to just a few microamps, making it perfect for battery-powered IoT projects. Voltage levels also differ. Arduino Uno works with 5 volts logic, while ESP32 is a 3.3 volts device. That means some sensors designed for Arduino may not directly work on ESP32 without level shifting, something beginners often overlook. This is where Arduino still shines. The Arduino IDE is incredibly simple. Plug in your board, select the example sketch, hit upload, and boom, LED blinking. And with ESP32, the process takes a few extra steps. You have to install board support in the IDE, and sometimes libraries may be trickier to set up. And it's not hard, but for a 12-year-old student learning coding for the first time, Arduino feels more friendly. Before we continue, there's an interesting twist happening in the Arduino world. In 2024, Arduino announced a partnership with Qualcomm to bring more powerful processors into their upcoming boards. While this sounds exciting, like adding AI, edge computing, and higher performance, it's also raising some eyebrows in the community. Arduino was born as an open source platform. You could design your own clones, modify the code, and freely share everything. But Qualcomm is known for proprietary technologies and strict hardware control. Many makers worry that this move might slowly fade the open source freedom that made Arduino popular in the first place. So imagine a future where you can't easily tinker with the board's firmware or modify its drivers because of licensing restrictions. Like, that would be completely change what Arduino stands for. Of course, Arduino claims they'll keep their community values intact, but as of 2025, the debate is still ongoing. Some makers are already exploring alternatives like ESP32, which remains open, affordable, and unrestricted. Connectivity is where ESP32 dominates. Out of the box, you can connect your ESP32 to Wi-Fi and send data to a server, build a web dashboard, or even control a robot from your phone using Bluetooth. But with Arduino, you need external modules like the ESP8266, which I hate at most, or some Bluetooth modules, which also adds cost and complexity. In 2025, IoT is everywhere, from smart homes to wearable devices. If you're working on projects that need wireless communication or needs communication, basically, the ESP32 is your way to go. Let's imagine two scenarios. You want to build a simple robotic arm for school. Arduino Uno, an ultrasonic sensor, a motor driver is more than enough. Easy to build, easy to code, tons of tutorials exist. Now imagine you want to monitor your garden soil moisture from anywhere in the world, or control lights in your home with your smartphone. That's where ESP32 shines. With just a few lines of code, it can connect to Wi-Fi and send your data to the cloud. And also, despite being more powerful, ESP32 boards are often cheaper. In 2025, you can find a basic ESP32 for around like $6 to $10. An official Arduino still costs $20 to $25. Clones are cheaper, but even then, ESP32 offers way more performance for less money. So here is the verdict. If you're an absolute beginner learning electronics or just starting your journey in coding and robotics, Arduino Uno is still a fantastic choice. It's stable, beginner-friendly, and well-supported. When deciding which board to use, always start with your project requirements. Do you need wireless? Do you care about battery life? Is it a simple beginner project or something you want to scale up? If it's simple, Arduino is the way to go. But if it's advanced or connected to the internet, ESP32. At the end of the day, Arduino and ESP32 aren't competitors. They're tools. Start the Arduino to learn the basics if you're a beginner, then move to ESP32 when your projects demand more power and connectivity. So which board do you prefer? Let me know in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials and experiments.